As a child, our Saturday shopping trip was into Chattanooga, Tennessee. I remember there was one fellow who impressed me walking the streets of Chattanooga. Old slouch hat, threadbare coat, dirty pants, and he carried an old beat-up guitar. I stood watching him one day, thinking that he would eventually play a tune on his guitar, because, you see, he was blind, or pretended to be blind, and he had a cup on the end of his guitar, which he hoped people would drop in their pennies, nickels, and dimes. Keep in mind, this was in late 1940, early 1950, somewhere along in there. I don't know how much money he ever made, but I kept watching and waiting one day for him to play a guitar, play something on his guitar. But all he ever did was pluck one string after another with a worn-out pick and twist the keys, always changing the tone of the string that he was plucking. And I watched and watched and waited for him to play a tune, but all he did was pluck a string and twist a key. Never played a single tune. Strings were dead on that guitar. He couldn't have played a tune on it if he had wanted to. And then it dawned on me that this fellow, he really could not even play a guitar. He did not have the foggiest idea about how to play a guitar. And I had learned a few chords myself, and I had learned that he certainly did not have any finger positions that would denote that he was familiar with even C or G or D or F or any of those other common guitar players. He was just pretending, putting on a show, plucking the string, twisting the key, to no purpose whatsoever other than just to make money. He was faking it. I've thought about that in light of my own life, and I wondered how much time I have spent simply plucking the keys or plucking the strings of a dead guitar, twisting the keys, dead strings, can't make a tune, just faking it. My prayer is that, Lord, for what I have learned, that I won't just fake it, but I will actually be able to play a tune for you. Literally play a tune, no, but just live an authentic life. Just do something that reflects that you are Lord and that you are Savior. It's not enough for us just to hold the Bible and pretend that we know what's in there. What we need to do is be able to play the Bible, read the Bible, understand measures of the Bible, and then try to live out of what we know is correct. Lord, help me not just to fake it, but to be real and to play a tune and not just pretend. Thank you for letting me be part of your day, and this is Don Howell with today's Minute Message.